Hello and welcome at Entering Mainstream Adoption, how the TUDelft and UTwente have collaboratively embraced open educational resources through Grasple. My name is Pim Bellinga, and in this 10-minute talk, I will tell the story of two universities who have moved from commercial publishers to open educational resources. And at the end, I will share our insights and recommendations if you are also in the process of making sure that large institutions adopt open educational resources. So if you want to go mainstream, this talk is for you. And in the coming minutes, we will go through three things. First, how did we get here? Then our experiences at the TU Delft and UTwente. And finally, what did we learn and what could you maybe learn from our experiences as well? 6 years ago, I was a statistics teacher at a university in the Netherlands, teaching journalism students about the basics of statistics. And I really like doing this, especially the interactive sessions, engaging with students. But I also found it quite challenging because what I noticed is that some students really needed more practice. And so like many other teachers, I found a solution in helping students to practice online. They could get immediate feedback. They could practice at their own time and their own pace. And they really liked this solution, this offering. But it also brought me to a challenge because where do I get enough resources for them to practice with? Now, one of the options was to use a commercial publisher. But the other option was to make sure that I would create all of these resources, all these exercises myself. But that would cost me a lot of time. But it also felt wasteful. What I really wanted to do is to make sure that we could work as a community together to build on top of each other's work. And so this idea of open collaboration is really something that I became very passionate about. And together with my co-founder, Thijs, a couple of years ago, we founded Grasple, which is a merger between the words grapple to struggle and grasp to understand. And our mission is to help instructors help learners to get from one to the other and to make sure that we can do that in an open environment and to build on top of each other's work. Now, what exactly did we do then over the past years? So one of the stories that I would like to share is from the TU Delft, a large technical university with over 24,000 students who really have a vision of open education. A few years ago in 2018, they ran into a challenge because what they wanted to do was offer a campus-wide math curriculum for all their 15,000 bachelor students. They had a program group called PRIME, Project Innovation in Mathematics Education. And the idea was really to make sure that students could practice more, could practice online, get immediate feedback. And just like me, they ran into this challenge. Where do we get the learning resources? Now, what they really wanted was to push for open. They wanted to prevent vendor lock-in. They wanted to be able to customize all of their resources. But they also really wanted to make sure that if they would use software for this, it had to be easy to use and to be reliable at a very large scale. And so finally, what they chose is to do a combination of two things. They would do it themselves. Actually, what they did is they asked all of their instructors to open their old file drawers and get out all of these old exercises to digitize them and to then offer it to students. But also to share that again with other organizations so that they could collaborate in a wider community. Now, finally, they chose Grasple as the software to use for this so they could collaborate on these materials easily. Edit them. They could create courses so that students could actively practice, and they could see with all of their insights what students were struggling with most, and then put attention there. And so, how that looks is it's all integrated into the learning management system. Students see the exercises, they practice, they get immediate feedback, and then what TU Delft did, and I find it very exciting. Is they really curated all of these exercises together with Grasple and then offer them all to the wider public under Creative Commons licenses. We also received an OER Collection Award from OE Global for this. And it's all available online for everyone to access. You don't need to log in. So definitely feel free to go there and to use these wonderful resources. And I'm very excited that still more is coming. So they're working now on curating the calculus exercises, but also video lessons, interactive lessons. So I would say it's really an example of a successful switch from commercial publishers to open educational resources. The second story that I would like to share is from the University of Twente. It's again a technical university in the Netherlands. They also wanted to create a standardized quality math curriculum, but they also really wanted to make sure that the software they would use for that would be really easy, because they really wanted to make sure that all of the exercises that they could use, they could edit easily, because they really wanted to control, but also to innovate. So their motivation was not per se to go for open. What they really wanted is to make sure that they could innovate, they could blend practicing with assessment. But what we found out is that even though this is a technical university in the same country, the curriculum is similar, but still slightly different. In order to really help them adopt OER quickly, what Grasple actually functioned as a temporary matchmaker. So what we did is we looked at their curriculum, saw what building blocks we could use from other OER collections, and especially from the TUDelft, and then sort of mix and match in order to fit that to the curriculum of the University of Twente. And then also functioned as a temporary publisher of open resources in order to fill the gaps, so that there would be one package that this university could easily adopt, so that it would be a full equivalent, a full alternative to the packages, the curated collections that commercial publishers would create and offer. And now what's really cool is they have done this adoption, and now they have more time to actually revise all the exercises, to remix them, and then to redistribute them back also to the TUDelft, who are now also using these revisions. And what we there see is now we really have this open collaboration. It's really these investments that are now combined into an ever-growing collection of open educational resources. Now, what have we learned from this? So to foster mainstream OER adoption, what we believe really helps is if you make sure your open educational resources are modular, so that they can easily be remixed to fit into a different context. What also really helps is if you create a tailored package so that it becomes a full alternative to the curated collections of commercial publishers. And finally, instructors are often time-pressed. And what really helps is if you create a supporting team that can support these instructors into finding, selecting, and curating the resources that they can then use in their education, and also to coordinate all of the work that the instructors are doing. But what we've also found is if we really want to enable a sustainable success, it means that you really want to keep track of all these resources. That becomes much harder now because there's much more resources, it therefore becomes much harder to keep track of them. And what could help there is also if you appoint a content manager internally who can actually do this coordination and keeping track. Find and create systems to keep track of this larger and dynamic collection of OER. We're now working on a version control system. So for those of you who know it, like GitHub is for code, we're now creating a version control system for open educational resources so that you can actually keep track of all these versions much more easily and much more organized. And secondly, we have drafted a set of key requirements for open educational software, which is not only for us, but for any software tool that you can use. Then we think you should be looking into these requirements because that really helps to keep track of that material. So let's work together to make open educational resources more open and more personal for everyone. And we would be very interested to collaborate with you in an open environment so that we can all make this happen. Thank you.